MS Dhoni versus Virat Kohli, team number one on the points table versus team number two. This is that big a clash that it has overshadowed the fact that there are two games today with Hyderabad versus Delhi to follow. Yes, we're talking Bangalore versus Chennai. It is an absolutely seismic clash, not just in the context of where the tournament is at this point, not just in the context of 2 points up to be gained from this, where the situation is as well, but also in terms of the momentum that these two teams are carrying at this point. We'll take a look at the first game, of course, of today, which is Bangalore versus Chennai, and then come to Hyderabad versus Delhi. We have to start with Bangalore versus Chennai because this is a big game. It really is. When you look at the matchups that are in play, the conditions that are going to be on offer, and also what could the win implicate for either of these teams, there is a lot to be gained and a lot to be lost as well. Let's take a closer look at these two teams. Let's first take a look at the game. This is the first 3:30 start at Wankhede. So the first afternoon game that is going to be played at the Wankhede, and the first afternoon game for CSK as well. RCB, of course, have already played an afternoon game, and we all saw what they did. Put up 200 plus total versus Kolkata. They were absolutely fabulous, destructive on the day. Maxwell, De Villiers, came to the party and really took Kolkata apart. Kolkata had nothing to say as well on that day. When you look at Chennai, yes, they've been very impressive at Wankhede after that first loss, but this is their first afternoon game. It'll be interesting to see how they go about it. Could be an interesting toss. I think it'll be a good toss to lose because the whole factor that's been at Wankhede, which is win the toss and bowl first, could go out of the window. The conditions are entirely different. There's no due on offer. There's no due to be thinking about at this point of time. But right, let's take a look at both these teams. Of course, three wins on the trot for Chennai after they lost their first game. RCB, four wins at the beginning of the season, not a single loss yet. They've looked absolutely amazing. They've ticked all the right boxes. They've got everything right as of now, and they're looking like the team to beat, to be honest, at this point of time. What have they done well? Let's talk about RCB first. I think the first thing that strikes you is that they got their death bowling sorted. They got their bowling role sorted, rather. Siraj, Harshal Patel, Yuzvendra Chahal, Washington Sundar, everybody has been given a clear set roles, and they've risen to the occasion. Especially Harshal Patel has come towards the end, picked up wickets, and is leading that purple cap chart at this point of time. He's looking very, very good, isn't he? But then after that confidence that Harshal Patel gave to the team in the first game, everybody else stepped up. So AB de Villiers, Glenn Maxwell, and then later Virat Kohli and Devdutt Padikkal versus RR. So it's a team that's feeding off each other. They're it looks like a bunch that's enjoying playing with each other, and I think these teams are the deadliest teams that really feed off each other's positive energy, and that's something that we have not seen with Bangalore in all of these years of the existence of the team in the IPL. They've looked like a team that's relied heavily on Virat Kohli and AB de Villiers, but now that's not looking like the case, and I think they've become a very, very dangerous unit, to say the least. I think they've been prolific with the bat, but surely with the ball as well, they've been very, very underrated, and that is a factor that CSK have to consider today as well as they take them on. I think they have to realize that everybody's focusing on Maxwell and AB and Virat and Padikkal, but silently the likes of Harshal Patel and co have been doing a fabulous job, and they cannot discount that out. What have CSK done well? To start off with, I think they've given the onus on their batters to go out there and play with a heavy strike rate. You've seen that in the last game as well, when they put up a big total on the board, that every single batter had a strike rate of above 150, with Faf leading the way, of course, with nearly scoring 100. Clear example said that they do not want to repeat last year's patterns. They realize the importance of scoring big on this kind of a surface, especially where they're playing. They're playing in Mumbai, and that is something that they'll be keen to do as well. Go out there and put the pressure back on Bangalore's bowlers. They've looked good so far, but they've never been tested. They've never been pushed. It's time for Chennai to probably step up and do that. I think that's going to be very, very important. Deepak Chahar has stepped up. And I think I think that has been a very, very important catalyst for Chennai speaking in terms of the bowling as well, which leads me well towards the matchups in this game. I think there are a couple of very mouth-watering matchups, and I think we spoke about Chahar, and I want to start with Chahar as well. Deepak Chahar versus the top order at Bangalore. I think Virat Kohli and Padikkal started the tournament with a little bit of cautious approach. They blew RR apart in the last game. This time they have a serious test. Chahar has picked up wickets in Mumbai. Yes, conditions will be different. He will not be bowling under the lights this time. Probably if he bowls first, if Chennai bowl first, but he's somebody who's picked up wickets on this surface. How do Bangalore's batters tackle Chahar's swing at the beginning will be an interesting one. He takes the ball into Devdutt Padikkal. Let's see how Padikkal reacts to that. Obviously, will take the ball away from Virat Kohli. Virat Kohli will be thinking about that at the back of his mind as well as he prepares for this game. Chahar has been a revelation. He's somebody who sets the tempo of CSK's bowling at the very beginning. And what he does today with the first 5-6 deliveries that come out of his hand could really set the tempo for Chennai. Will be very, very important indeed. The second matchup that I'm really excited about is Harshal Patel, Mohammad Siraj versus CSK's middle order. I think the middle order CSK has looked good. They've been underrated. They've done the job silently. Not really. There's not been a lot of shosha about them. Raina stepped up in the first game. Later, they've been consistent performances from the likes of Jadeja, Karan. Bravo stepped up in one of the odd games as well. So I think there's been some consistent performances from that team, and the way they finish their batting innings will be very important as well. And that'll be where the likes of Harshal Patel and Siraj will be bowling. That'll be a very, very good contest. A couple of youngsters there versus the experienced pros in CSK, some youngsters in CSK as well. I think I would love that contest. The third and the most interesting contest of the lot is Maxwell versus Moeen Ali. These are two maverick superstar players. I think Maxwell plays spin very, very well. He hits that reverse sweep absolutely well. Reverse switch hit, whatever you want to call it. But he plays spin well. And it'll be interesting to see how Moeen goes about his business. He's bowled very well so far. I think picked up some crucial wickets in the mid-overs for Chennai. How does he tackle the threat of Glenn Maxwell, who's arguably looked one of the best batters in this tournament so far? All in all, I think a couple of fabulous, fabulous contests. But at this point, to stop the Bangalore juggernaut, it requires a Chanakya. And is it the time for MS Dhoni to step in and stop the Bangalore juggernaut? Everybody's waiting for Bangalore to slip up. And this could be the game where Chennai could come in and really lay out a trap for Bangalore to fall in, and they could succumb to it. Or can Bangalore just destroy Chennai like they've destroyed every other team that they faced? All in all, I think it's going to be a great game. The afternoon start is going to be a factor for sure, without a shadow of a doubt. We could see teams making changes, but I really doubt it. All in all, I think at this point, I think Bangalore is a little are slight favorites for me. But if, like I said, if there is one team that can stop Bangalore, it's Chennai. For sure. All right, let's take a look at the evening game. It's Delhi versus Hyderabad. So much conversation about Bangalore versus Chennai. All you know, it could prove out to be a dull game, and the second game could prove to be interesting. It happens a lot in the IPL, I'll tell you that. Delhi versus Hyderabad. I think both teams coming in on the back of wins. Hyderabad's first win, and that would give them confidence. But Delhi beat defending champions Mumbai, got revenge for the loss in the final in 2020, and really decimated Mumbai. After Mumbai got a good start, they pulled them back, and Mishra bowled fabulously well. Amit Mishra, an absolute veteran of the game, pulled Delhi back into the game, and then the batters did the job for Delhi. They'll be coming into this with a lot of confidence. They really will. Both will be confident, but I think a big game for Hyderabad because they want to carry the momentum forward, right? They won their first game of the tournament after playing all these games, and now they want to build on that. They want to get some momentum in and continue this process of winning. I think a couple of things that they did well in the last game, of course, they got Williamson in. And that really, really made a factor. You all know how big a fan I am of the Iceman. He's a massive player, not just from a batting perspective, but also what he brings to Hyderabad, a sense of calmness amidst all the fire and all that Hyderabad possess. And they also got in Kedar Jadhav. Siddharth Kaul was an addition as well. Drop Manish Pandey. Everybody's been calling for that. And then finally, Hyderabad have agreed to that I'm sitting on the fence with that. Not really sure. I really like Manish Pandey, but at this point, is the manner in which he was going about his batting, was it the right thing to do? Probably was. I think the batting's looking good. If you look at the top four, Warner, Bairstow, Williamson, and either Kedar Jadhav or Virat Singh, that's a very good top four, and it is the top four that we know from Hyderabad from all these years. Consistent, reliable, and potent. Very, very good top four. And then followed by, of course, either Kedar Jadhav, Virat Singh, whoever bats at five, Shankar, Abhishek, and Abdul Samad, which is not a bad top six, top seven at all. I think it's looking very good at this point of time, and they would want to take the attack to the likes of Rabada and Avesh Khan and Ashwin, who are not having the best of seasons at this point of time. Avesh Khan's having a good one. I think Avesh Khan and Mishra will be key for Delhi, but the others would also want to get back into form, but at this point, they're not doing very well. If we talk about Hyderabad's bowling, of course, this is a bowling team, without a shadow of a doubt. Rashid's been amazing, as always. I think he would want to pick up more wickets. He's been very economical, but he would want to pick up more wickets for sure. The others have been absolutely amazing as well. I think all in all, couple of changes Hyderabad made. Khalil has come in. I think Siddharth Kaul has come in as well. Khalil looked good. He's the replacement for Natarajan. Natarajan's out for the season. He's looked good. But I think Hyderabad will have their hands full because they're facing a Delhi team that has Shikhar Dhawan at the top, who's been in the runs. He's been scoring a lot of consistent runs. Prithvi Shaw's looked good as well. Last few games, he's not clicked as much, but he will come good at some point for sure. He definitely will. Steve Smith has looked good since he's come into bat at three. I think they've gotten that right, and he'll have that confidence with Steve Smith. And then, of course, you have Lalit Yadav, and then you have Rishabh Pant and Hetmyer to follow, which is a decent batting attack, really is. What do Hyderabad need to do to win this game? I think get Shikhar and Prithvi back in the hat. Put the pressure on Steve Smith. That is going to be a very important factor. And that, because Hyderabad is a bowling side, you want to execute your bowling plans well and then get your batting to do the job. Yes, that's an indirect way to say it doesn't matter. Yes, you want to bat first on this Chennai surface. You can think about bowling first because you've done well in the past. You've done well in the past with that strategy. Replicated this time, right? Do what's familiar with you, especially when you're in a precarious situation. I think all in all, I think, to be honest, the couple of matchups that I'm looking forward to, I'm very excited about, is Shikhar versus Bhuvi. I think they are two marquee players, two legendary players in the modern game for India. And what Bhuvneshwar Kumar does at the top versus Shikhar will be very important. If he can get that ball to go away from Shikhar at the last moment, which he can do, he has the ability to do it. It could prove to be a different game completely, as everybody is expecting. And then, of course, in the middle order, in the middle overs rather, Mishra versus Williamson is a game that I'm really, really looking forward to. It's a matchup I'm looking forward to. All in all, I think it's going to be a great game. It's being played at Chennai. It's one of the last games at Chennai as a venue. The caravan moves from Chennai and Mumbai to Ahmedabad and Delhi in the next few days, and it's going to be a lot of fun. It's going to be a lot of fun as we do that. And well, it's going to be a lot of fun on cricketnews.com as well. Like, share, and subscribe to us. You can follow me at SUMEDHHBILGI. That's Sumedh Bilgi on all social media platforms. And we will be there to bring you all the latest from all things IPL. Stay tuned. Keep these with you. And follow www.cricketnews.com as you enjoy all the action. Have a great Sunday. Stay home, stay safe.